Hello friends, this is Durga again from Technology Mentor / IT Varsity. As part of setting up plain vanilla Hadoop on a VM and running MapReduce programs, so far we have covered how to create a template and then clone the VM from it and do the necessary prerequisites, download Hadoop binaries and set the Java home in Hadoop env.sh, and we have tested this command Hadoop fs -ls, which returns the details of our files in the current directory. Okay, but if you see, there are right now we have not started any daemon process in Hadoop. We just run the command, so it runs in local mode and it will read the OS level file system when you do not start any of the daemon process. And you can see this warning, util.native code loader. This might not be issue to start our Hadoop services like name node, data node, etc. But when it comes to using compression and all those things, it will cause some issues. For that reason, I am trying to cover how to compile the native libraries so that you don't see this warning, and all the compression algorithms you are interested in will work as expected. So yet we are not talking about the Hadoop daemon process. We are actually talking about compiling the Hadoop source code so that we can generate the native libraries which will be used at the time of compression. Okay. For that, what we have to do is I am working on script. So far we have taken care of downloading, installing telnet and wget. And then we have downloaded Hadoop 2.7.1 binaries, and we have set up our bash profile and ran it. And also we have set up the Java home to whatever we have before. But to set up Maven and also to the latest version of Maven and to compile using Maven, JDK 1.7 did not work for me. There might be a way to get around it and use Maven against 1.7 also, because the documentation says that it is compatible with 1.7, but for some reason it did not work. So, but using JDK 1.8 worked for me. So again, I am using wget here, and I am trying to download JDK. Let me do this. Let me actually go to the other node which I used for testing and copy it directly from there, because this will take time and also it will waste some of my internet. But this is the command you need to use. I will try to put it in GitHub, I will try to put it in GitHub very soon so that you can receive this, this script in my GitHub account also. So let me do scp root at 192.168.225.30. Come on, why are you taking so long? Okay, for some reason it is hanging. I will troubleshoot it later. For now, let me do this. It will take little time to download this. So in this case, this wget no check certificate is to bypass the so when you try to download Java directly from Oracle, it will ask you to acknowledge and then only it will enable the downloadable link. In this case, we are trying to bypass using this wget command, no check certificate, no cookies and all those things. And also we are passing Oracle license to accept as part of this. And it is pretty fast. It is downloading at decent speed, so let us wait for some time and then we will see how can we set this up. So almost completed. Now I am entering it. and then I have created the directory optjdk180045, and then I copied all the files from the current location, which is untarred, to this location, and then I created a soft link to that. And now I have to go to my bash profile, and I need to update Java Home to this, so that Maven picks up this one while executing the, while compiling the source code to generate our native libraries. Okay, once that is done, what you have to do is, again, whenever we set the environment variables in our bash profile, it is better to run that as a script like this. And then we can download Maven, whatever is the latest version. As of now, 3.3.3 is the latest version. I'm downloading the tar file for the binaries. You can Google it and get the latest version without any issues. And now I'm copying, I'm using wget to get it. So now Maven is downloaded. I need to untar it, and then I have to create the soft link. And the soft link is also created. And now I am creating this environment variables and appending the path. Appending m2_home/bin to the path. So the purpose of appending m2home/bin, m2home resolves to root maven. So we are actually adding root maven bin to path. The purpose of that is, if we don't do that, we cannot run maven command from the directory we want. So let me first export this one. So it is exported to bash.profile. So even after running the bash_profile, if you do maven, it says command not found. If you append to the path, make sure when you are adding to path, you append to the existing one. That's where this dollar path comes into picture. Dollar path resolves into the current path, and then it will append to, and then the m2home/bin will be appended to that. So I copied it, pasted it, and then I'm running the bash profile script again, and then I'm running a maven version command. Okay, let me do ls-ltr root maven. Okay, there is a typo in my bash profile. That's why it was failing. Let me fix it. /bash profile. And okay, this is not the issue. The issue is I need to unlink Maven, and then ln-s Apache maven-3.3.3 without bin. Earlier I have the bin in the script, that's why it failed. Now I can do ls-ltr, and now I can see -mvn-v, and it gives the version. So it is using 1.8.0_45 Java version to while so Maven will use that version. So let me update the script here real quick. Here I need to remove the bin. Now we have the Maven, and also as part of the last video itself, we actually downloaded the source code for Hadoop. If you want, you can look at this. This is the source tar.gz, but we didn't untar it. If you see, the source.tar.tg is much smaller than the binaries, because most of the dependencies are not there. It's just a source code, all Java programs with pom.xml, which defines the dependencies. When we compile it, all the dependencies will be downloaded, and then the code will be compiled. And then if you look at the tar file size, it might be equal to this 210 MB than 18 MB as of now. Okay, that being said, we need to do tar xdf to untar this one. and hit enter. Now it is untarred. Then you have to you can validate that there are bunch of files in this. So the demonstration which I am doing is on CentOS, and if you want to and there are multiple things which you need to execute to compile using native libraries. So if you want to do it in Ubuntu, you can look at this building.txt, and they have provided scripts over there. So if you do cat hadoop -2.7.1src and building.txt, so it has given commands referring all Ubuntu syntax. So before actually running the Maven to compile, you have to install quite a few packages so that everything works as expected. So apt-get is similar to yum. Yum is for CentOS and apt-get is for Ubuntu. You can use this building.txt and you can follow this one wherever you see yum install as part of our script. So before compiling, we need to install all these packages. So actually the native libraries are nothing but compiled C code, and for that we need to have C compiler, C maker and all those things. So these will take care of all the required components. So you just copy these things and then paste it here, and it will download all the packages for you and install them for you. It will take a while to download and install all these things. Once it is done, we will go ahead and look at the rest of the topics. Sometimes because of typos or if the VM cannot connect to some of the mirrors which are defined in yum repository files, there might be some failures. So it is very important for you to review if there are any failures when the installation is done by using yum commands. And also, unless you install all these packages, you will see one or the other issue when you try to compile the source code using Maven later. Okay, so now, and also to compile it, it requires something called protobuf, or I think it's protobuf. So there is a typo here. It is from Google code, so you can actually download it and untar it, and then you have to make the code also. So this script is not complete. I will fix that in a moment. So now it is actually downloading protoc, and it actually untarred using xfj command, and because it is using bzip, not gzip here, probably that's why they have used j here. I'm not 100% sure on that. Then pushd will take you to the directory wherever this protobuf 250 is there. And then, so once you run this pushd command, you need to run /configure. All these things will take little time, and it's better to run one at a time because these are completely new to many of us. And if you skip, if you run everything together, and if it takes, you might get inconsistent messages. So better run one step at a time and see if there are no issues in each and every step. Okay, this step will take around 30 minutes to 1 minute, and once that is done, we will do the make install. And protobuf is required while we compile our Hadoop source code using Maven. So unless you want to use compression, this is not required, especially for development and R&D stuff. But if you want to explore compression also as part of your plain vanilla single node Hadoop cluster, it is better to do this Maven compile, and also it will help you to understand how Maven works, and it can come handy in many ways in future. So it's better to do this exercise even if compression is not part of your R&D while learning Hadoop on this plain vanilla Hadoop, plain vanilla single node Hadoop cluster. So now it is done, and now I am running make install command, and it's better to run protoc and then check the version of it. It is very important that it is either 2.5.0 or higher when you want to compile for Hadoop 2.7.1. So you need to understand those dependencies. If the there is a dependency mismatch, if you are using different version than 2.5.0, especially earlier versions, then you might not be able to compile your Hadoop source code to generate your native libraries. That being said, now we need to go to home directory and then run ls-ltr command, go to Hadoop 2.7.1 src directory, and then you have to run. Okay, first you need to reboot the server. After setting up protoc buff, it's better to reboot. So I'm rebooting the server. So now I logged in. Better to go to cd Hadoop 2.7.1 source. And before actually getting into that, it's better to run this command Hadoop check native minus a. So it will confirm whether our stuff is working or not. In this case, everything says false. So nothing, there are no native libraries at all for any of the compression algorithms, and also for Hadoop and also OpenSSL. Okay. So now we will try to compile our source code and update our lib/native directory on our original location where we have binaries. And then we will run this command again and you will see the difference. So what you need to do here is you need to run this command mvn package -p dist native script test tar. So dist will confirm that once compiled you will see a target directory. Here if you see, currently there is only pom.xml, but once you compile under Hadoop -dist, so here it says dist, so which means I think distribution, under -dst you will see a target directory and you will see all the native libraries over there. So -p is the control argument which will tell you to use these two things, and -dist script test will not run any tests test cases, and -d tar will actually tar the compiled code into a package. Okay, so that is the purpose of this maven package command, and you can hit enter. So you have to go to the source directory wherever we have untarred our code, source code of Hadoop 2.7.1, and then on the home directory of Hadoop 2.7.1 source you have to run this command. And it will take a lot of time, at least 5 to 7 minutes to download this, and it can be significantly different depending upon the download speed you are getting while running this command on your PC. So and also sometimes you might see some errors. It will be better to run multiple times if you see errors and confirm that error is recurring, rather than troubleshooting the issues immediately you see the first error. We will see if there will be any errors this time, or it will complete in the first run itself. If it completes in the first run, we will be very lucky. So it's been almost 3 minutes and still it's going on without any issues. I hope it will be successful. So still it's going, it's downloading a lot of stuff. It's almost close to 7 to 8 minutes now. I'm not sure how far we are done, and I will come back once the downloading portion is done. Okay, now the download portion is done. Majority of download portion is done. Now it is slowly getting into compilation portion. Let's see, it's almost like 10 to 12 minutes since we started this, but so far there are no issues, it's running fine. And also, just for your information, I think there is a way in Maven where you can fork multiple threads and download these binaries using binaries in parallel. If you are familiar with that, try to use that. It can cut down the compilation time considerably, especially the downloading portion of it. So now it failed with error, and it failed at common. And let us see what error it is giving. It is saying Hadoop common project, Hadoop common target native, no such file or directory. I think I need to install cmake. Let me see. yaml -y install cmake. Yeah. So let me include that also. Okay, now let me run the command again. This time it will not take that time, that long. All the downloads are happened, so it will directly get into the compilation. Yeah, now it is actually compiling the stuff without any issues. Earlier, because we don't have CMake, it failed, but it resumed wherever from where it got stopped, where it got errored out after installing CMake. So it is going to other packages. So there are many packages under 2.7.1. If you want to look at that, let me open another window. SSH root at hadoop2.7.itvarsity.com. It is still compiling. We are logging into the another window. Okay, if you go to hadoop2.7.1/source, you can see bunch of Hadoop directories here. So each one is kind of a different package. So Hadoop common is one project, Hadoop HDFS is another project, Hadoop yarn is another project, Hadoop MapReduce is another project, and then the overall Hadoop package includes sub packages of all these things, and it is trying to compile each and every package one after the other. And it will take considerable amount of time to do that, especially when you are compiling the code manually. So it is still downloading. It seems my internet is pretty slow, almost 20 minutes. It took almost 20 minutes and it's still going on without any issues, except the issue which popped up because of not having CMake. Now the compilation is done. Because we use -d tar at the end, it is actually creating the tar file now, which is packaging everything together, and it is also doing gzip on top of that. So we are almost close to done, and then we need to copy the files from native directory which is compiled to our original location where we have the executable jars. So here, if you see, everything looks successful, and also while it is running, you might be seeing some exceptions, but you can ignore them unless it fails the Maven build. That being said, now if you go to Hadoop dist, there is a target directory here. You need to go there, and then there will be Hadoop 2.7.1 directory here, and then there will be lib here. And then go to native, ls-ltr. What I will do is I will do cp-rs native. We need to copy it to Hadoop, which we have created soft link on top of Hadoop 2.7.1 binaries, and lib, and here. I don't know why, even though I have given -rf, it has prompted me for each and every file. I am not 100% sure on that. Anyway, I am going to now lib native and lsltr. You can see all the files here. That being said, now run Hadoop fs-ls. We have not created our cluster yet. We are still running locally only. And earlier when we run this command, we have seen some warning related to native libraries. And now it will not show the show that warning. Okay. And then to actually, we have seen this command called Hadoop check native. We have run earlier and you have seen everything as false. So now we are doing Hadoop check native minus a, and you can see that most of them are true except for bzip. And if you want to set up bzip, what you have to do is m-y install bzip2 and also bzip2 devel, and hit enter. It will download both bzip2 as well as development packages, and then you can again go to Hadoop source, hadoop 2.7.1-source, and then you can actually run our maven command again. Now it will be compiling for the bzip as well. It will compile native libraries for the bzip compression algorithm as well. I can do this earlier also, but intentionally I have delayed so that you know how to add new compression algorithms to it if it is supported by Hadoop. First you need to download the software related to that compression algorithm, and then you have to take care of compiling the code to get the native libraries, and again you have to copy them. This time it will be very fast because most of the stuff is already there. Only probably the binaries related to bzip has to be downloaded by Maven before compiling the code. So almost done. Just for this it took around 4 to 5 minutes just to compile the code without much downloads. So it is a painfully time taking process, and to get this everything sorted out it took almost 24 hours to 28 hours for me over a span of 2-3 days. And but I am able to condense everything within 20 minutes to 30 minutes video. Even though there are not much issues with my script, still it will take around 3 to 4 hours for you to nail this down. Anyway, that being said, now let me go to the directory again, where so it should be in Hadoop dist target Hadoop 2.7.1 lib native. Okay, so this one we have to copy to our original Hadoop directory where we have created softlink. Now you can actually do check, and even bzip will be true. Okay, so this is how you have to check your the source code to generate the native libraries, and you have to copy those to relevant location. It is very important to understand this process, especially if you want to play with plain vanilla Hadoop, because one of the student reached out to me that he needs some help regarding how to compile these native libraries so that he can use Snappy algorithm for his MapReduce programming, because it is part of his assignment, and that's made me to spend time and come up with this video, and also the overall idea of setting up Hadoop on a single node and also run MapReduce programs on that. The advantage of this will be it will be far more productive even on some low-end computers. Even if you have 4 GB or 6 GB laptop, still you can create a VM with 2 GB RAM, and you can take care of all these things, and you can run your MapReduce program successfully on a simulated Hadoop cluster running on single node. That being said, as part of future videos, I will start working on explaining a little bit about Hadoop core components, and start one service after the other, and then we will see how we can run MapReduce programs, and then I will try to integrate with my other playlist where I have almost 60 videos to cut the corners of complex MapReduce programming and start using it effectively. I hope you are enjoying the content so far on my channel. If you like a particular video, please click on like button. If you want to provide feedback or have a technical question on a particular video, please use the comment section. And also you can reach out to me on my Facebook page or LinkedIn or anywhere where, and it is available in the comment section of my video about my contact information. And also, if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. You will see a lot more content than just Hadoop or big data over time. Thank you. Bye.